was also worried. He went to Oliver's house to look for him. James said, "I just thought maybe that he was sick, and I didn't know if he was unconscious in the house. I didn't know." Oliver was nowhere to be found. 3 days later, his car was discovered just a few blocks from his home. One tire was flat. School papers and a sack lunch were on the front seat, but there was no sign to suggest what had happened to Oliver. Detective Goodwin stated, "At that time, I felt that there was something wrong. Then the decision was made here that we were looking at a kidnapping or a homicide." Dennis Watson became a prime suspect. During an investigation, police discovered that two other witnesses scheduled to testify against Watson in previous trials had also died under mysterious circumstances. 10 years earlier, in 1973, a man named Glenn, had burned to death in a car registered to Watson. Glenn was scheduled to testify against Watson in an armed robbery trial the very next day. Based on the testimony of another witness, Watson was indicted for Glenn's murder. However, this new witness suddenly died of a suspicious drug overdose, and the murder charges were dropped. And now, Oliver Munson was missing, but with no evidence to implicate Watson, the investigation stalled. Then, police heard from a man named Hilton Solomon. Hilton's car had been stolen just hours before Oliver disappeared. Inside the car, Hilton found a hat that would later be identified as similar to one owned by Oliver Munson. Detective Goodwin said other evidence was also found in the car. Hilton's son Solomon took his car home after it was released by Baltimore City and decided to clean the car. While he was cleaning, he found several receipts from a video store. On these receipts was the name Oliver Munson. When we went down to look at the car, we looked underneath the seat, and right by the track of the right-hand front seat, I found a spent cartridge case. Red smudges were also found on one of the receipts, and tests revealed that the stains were human blood. Type O positive. Authorities believe this was proof that Oliver had been murdered, but with no records showing his blood type and no other hard evidence, the official investigation reached a dead end. Oliver's disappearance had no apparent effect on the outcome of Watson's car theft trial. He pleaded guilty and was sentenced to 10 years in prison. He was paroled in 1989 after serving half his term. However, Oliver Munson has never been found. A lot of people blame the police for Oliver's disappearance because they said that they set him up to testify, knowing how Watson operated, and that they shouldn't have done that, knowing that two other witnesses before Oliver had died under mysterious circumstances. I believe that Watson killed Oliver. I mean, he was going to testify 3 days after, and he just vanished and was never heard from again. Unfortunately, I think that's what happened. And I also think that it's the police's fault because they shouldn't have done that. He wasn't, you know, he wasn't safe, and it was very dangerous for him to testify. They basically forced him to, and he didn't want want to, but he knew that he didn't have a choice. And the fact that he was nervous about